नमस्ते, आई एम डॉक्टर जूही सिंह, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट ज्योति विद्यापीठ विमेंस यूनिवर्सिटी एट द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फैकल्टी ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिकल साइंसेज. सो टुडेज आवर टॉपिक इज टिश्यू कल्चर. टिश्यू कल्चर इज डिवाइडेड इंटू प्लांट टिश्यू कल्चर एंड एनिमल टिश्यू कल्चर. प्लांट टिश्यू कल्चर इज इन विट्रो कल्टिवेशन ऑफ द प्लांट सेल एंड और टिश्यू अंडर द असेप्टिक और कंट्रोल एनवायरमेंट कंडीशन इन लिक्विड और इन सेमी सॉलिड वेल डिफाइंड न्यूट्रिएंट मीडियम फॉर द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ द प्राइमरी और सेकेंडरी मेटाबोलाइट्स और टू रीजनरेट द प्लांट्स. ओके, इन अदर वर्ड वी कैन ऑल्सो कॉल इट इज एन एक्सपेरिमेंटल टेक्निक थ्रू विच द मास ऑफ द सेल विच इज कॉल्ड अ कैलस इज प्रोड्यूस फ्रॉम द एक्स प्लांट टिश्यूज. द कैलस प्रोड्यूस through in this process can be utilized directly to regenerate plantlets or to extract or manipulate some primary or secondary metabolites. The plant tissue culture refer to the cultivation of plant cell which normally form a multicellular tissue. When grown on the agar media, the tissue form a callus or mass of undifferentiated cells. The techniques of cell tissue culture is convenient for the starting and maintaining the cell lines as well as study pertaining to organogenesis and meristem culture. This technique in vitro cultivation of plant cell or organs is primarily devoted to solve two basic problems. To keep the plant cell or organ free from the microbes, to ensure the desired development in cell or organ by providing suitable nutrient media and other environment conditions. So there are the different advantages of the tissue culture. Availability of the raw material. Some plants are difficult to cultivate and are also not available in abundance, and tissue culture techniques is considered a better source for the regular and uniform supply of the raw material for medicinal plant industry for production of phytopharmaceutical. Next is advantages of tissue cultures are fluctuation in supply and quality. The method of production of crude drug is variable in quality due to the changes in the climate, crop diseases and seasons. All these problems can overcome the tissue culture. New method of isolation. It is possible to obtain new method of ice for isolation and newer compound from plants by this technique, for which the patient or a patent right can be obtained. Biotransformation is another advantage. Biotransformation means the process through which the functional group organic compound are modified by the living cell. Reactions are feasible by using the plant cell culture. Disease cell and desired propagules. Disease-free and desired propagules. Large-scale production of the plant with disease-free and desired propagule can store and maintain without any damage during the transportation for the subsequent plantation. Biosynthetic pathway. Tissue culture can be used for the tracing the biosynthetic pathway of secondary metabolites using labeled precursor in the tissue culture media. Immobilization of the cell is the next advantage of the tissue culture. Tissue culture can be used for the plant preservation by immobilization of the cell, further facilitating transportation and biotransport. Next, continuous uniform biomass is obtained. Medicinally important compound. Large scale production of plant with diseases free and desired propagules could be stored and maintained without any damage during the transportation of subsequent plantation. Next advantage, biosynthetic pathway. Tissue culture can be used for tracing the biosynthetic pathway of secondary metabolites using the labeled precursor in the culture media. Immobilization of the cell. Tissue culture can be used for the plant preservation and immobilization of the cell, further facilitating tissue transportation and biotransformation, which we already told you. Next advantage is that medicinally important compound can be synthesized, which can be synthesized chemically. Next is useful natural compound can be produced independent of the soil condition and changes in the climatic conditions. Improvement of the medicinal plant species is another advantages of the tissue culture. Propagation of plant without seed is defined and controlled condition is another advantages of tissue culture. Next is disadvantages. There are the advantages and disadvantages. So the different disadvantages of the tissue culture are: high level of expertise is required. Next, a small error may lead to complete collapse of the product or the plant. Lot of chemicals are required for the plant tissue culture, which must contain high purity. There is no chance for evaluation in the of mutation. Culture of a culture on artificial medium may lead to depression of unusual metabolic pathway, which led not to be beneficial to the biotechnologist. Next, in majority cases, amount of secondary metabolites produced is negligible. The protocols for the individual plants differ very widely, and changes in the medium, constitution, and environmental parameter affect the rate of the cell growth and accumulation of the secondary metabolites. The maximize on the cell mass produce the cell suspension culture eventually become very dense and then present problem of even the aeration. Next disadvantage is instability and then slow growth, very expensive process, aseptic condition are required, and aseptic condition are to be maintained throughout of the growth of the plant. These are the advantages and disadvantages of the plant tissue culture. So there is a historical development of the plant tissue culture or tissue culture. The principle of the tissue culture was evolved in 1839 and 1838 in cell theory, advanced by the Schwann and Sheldon, which we already know that. From 1902, Herbert Land proposed the concept of in vitro cell culture, and then sequentially in 1904 Henning cultured embryo from the several cruciferous species, and then in 1922 Colte and Robian successfully cultured the root and stem tip respectively. 1926 when discovered first plant growth hormone is indole acetic acid. In 1934, White introduced vitamin B as a growth supplement in tissue culture media of tomato root tea. In 1939, Gotrat, White, and Novkot establish endless proliferation of the callus culture. In 1941, Overbeck was the first to add the coconut milk for the cell division in Dhatura. In 1946, Wolf raised whole plant of the lupinus by the shoot tape culture. In 1954, Murray was the first to break the callus tissue into the single cell. And then forward to 1957, Schug and Miller gave the concept of hormonal control of the organ formulation. In 1959, Wien and Stewart regenerated embryo from the callus clump and cell suspension of Doukas, Korda. Then come forward 1960. In 1960, Cocking was the first to isolate the protoplast by the enzyme degradation of the cell wall. In 1960, Bergman filtered cell suspension and isolated single cell by planting. In 1962, Schoog developed MS media for higher salt concentration. And then 1962, Kanta and Maheshwari developed test tube fertilization technique. Then in 1966, Tuart demonstrated totipotency by the regenerating carrot plant from the single cell of the tomato. So these are the history of the tissue plant culture. Basic requirement of the plant tissue culture is plant material, equipment, glass, aseptic condition, washing and storage facilities, media preparation, sterilizing room, nutrient media, transfer room, culture room, incubator, proper optimum aeration, well equipped observation recording room. These are the basic requirement for the plant tissue culture medium. Like plant material, we have to the requirement is plant material. The plant material should be the disease free and isolated to be old. Also the particular species, variety, genotype which are used should be the right one. Generally in vitro germinated seedling are frequently chosen as the seed. Is often much more readily sterilized than the softer plant tissue culture. Example, a particular internode, the youngest fully expanded leaf. Next, equipment of the glass and the glass frame like incubating chamber, laminar flow, incubator, autoclave, refrigerator, hot air oven, microscope, pH meter, washing equipment, etc. Then aseptic condition, the plant material, tissue equipment, culture media and the room should be the free from the microbe. Usually dry heat, wet heat, ultra filtration chemicals are used for the sterilization process. Then come forward to the surface sterilization of the plant material such as seed, fruit, stem, leaf, etc. by the agents like 9-10% calcium hypochlorite for the 3 to 30 minutes. 2% of sodium hypochlorite solution for 5 to 30 minutes. The material need to be washed thoroughly in the double distilled water after sterilizing in the solution. 10 to 12% in hydrogen hypoxide solution for the 5 to 15 minutes and then 1 to 2% bromine water for the 2 to 10 minutes. After that, 1% of the solution of chlorine water, mercury chloride, silver nitrate and antibiotic etc. can be used. Absolute alcohol is used for the hard tissues. So these are the aseptic conditions which is used. Dry heat method is used for the sterilization. Equipment in the heat hot air oven. Washing and storage facilities are there. Media room are there. And well equipment observations are recording areas there. Basic methodology and techniques of plant tissue culture. The general technique used in the isolation and growth of the culture is described. Like firstly we have to prepare the suitable nutrient media. As per the selection of the plant media is autoclave. Selection of the explant, any excised part of the healthy plant has been used. Has to be used like bud, leaf, root, seed, etc. Sterilization of explant by the sodium hypochlorite, mercury chloride and washed aseptically for 6 to 10 times with the sterilized water. Inoculation, the sterilized explant is inoculated on solidified nutrient media under aseptic condition. Culture media incubated to 25 degrees Celsius and relative humidity up to 50 to 70% for the 16 hours of the photo period. After that, the regeneration occur. Plantlets regenerated after transferring a portion of callus into the another medium and inductions of the root and shoot or directly from the explant. Then hardening is gradually explored exposed by the plantlets and acclimations to the environment condition. Plantlet transfer. Plantlets are transferred to the greenhouse to the field condition. Thank you. If you have any query, please comment below.